evening, friends. 3 o'clock on the dot, and we're so glad to see all of you here. My name is Dave Crocker, and I'm just glad to be here. You get the phone line, it's like, hey, I got it this morning. So good to have you here. It's a 50th anniversary celebration that I can never imagine that we would have reached when we started up. But you're going to enjoy the show, I'm sure. Before we begin, I want to tell you a little bit about our MC because of the special contributions he's made over many years to our success. In Mansfield, Ohio, as you mentioned, barbers shop, people say Rusty Cates. Well, where's Rusty, Dave? I haven't seen him. What did I say? I didn't mean that. Rusty, his contributions are very difficult to try to cover it all in a short time. And so I'll put it this way. Rusty began singing with us in 1977, and he was just a sophomore at Madison High School. And he continued active with us until about 2011, maybe minus a year or two. So 30-some years. And by the way, people say, well, why didn't he continue? He went into competitive singing with larger choruses, those who really want to compete at the international level. And he's been doing that very successfully. So he's happy, and that quartet is really a big part of his life, I'll tell you that. But getting back to the Fun Center Quartet, I could see from the time we met him, this is a kid with creative mind and energy and talent. And he put it together for us both musically as far as being a section leader and assistant director, but his forte was show production. You could hand him 12 songs and say, Rusty, we want to sing these 12 songs, make a show of them. And he would do that, and it would be nothing. And even tonight, the set you see and the idea of having the interviews, that's Rusty Cates right up front. So we're certainly very lucky to have him with us. And he did, I don't know if I mentioned, he did 26 of our shows, show production-wise, in that 37 years, and also was our MC for 19 years. And so tonight, I ask you to help me welcome Rusty Cates as our MC for the 20th time. Rusty Cates.
Thank you very much, Dave. I do want to say, a lot of people know who I am. My involvement with local radio, WMAN, for close to 37 years. But through this, I was a barbershop singer long before I started working on the radio. So we will begin our show momentarily.
By the seat of my pants. And by that I mean And but I knew some fellows were gathering to try to get something started. And so when I went to the first meeting, Glenn Fisher, Mansfield City School teacher, was their interim director. And so we started working together, and he said to me in one intermission or break, rehearsal break, why don't you take the second half of the rehearsal day? And I thought, well, okay. And I probably played a dirty trick on the guys in that I knew some tags or short little endings of songs that had these powerful, bombastic, hair-raising, goose-pumping chords in them. And I hit them with as many of them as we could, and they were like, well, I don't know what that was, but we're going to keep doing it for a long time to come. So we all went to the seat of our pants from there and just kept loving it, working it, getting education on it. That was the story.
Glenn Fisher was happy to step aside and let that young buck take over. Well, you eventually served as the frontline director for 20 years and directed 22 annual shows, along with countless community performances. Dave, it's about time we shared a few songs from the chorus's first decade, and you will be directing. Do you still have it?
You bet.
The start of the show is now at Alabama High School, and also featured our sponsoring chapter, the Bucyrus Country Gentlemen. When the curtain went up, the MC said something like this. Ladies and gentlemen, under the direction of Dave Crocker, the Fun Center Chordsman.
Oh.
you definitely still got it. Now, during the first decade, the Fun Center Quartzmen had six shows at Malabar High School and one at John Simpson. Then in 1982, held the first of many annual shows at the Renaissance Theater. Community support for the chorus was tremendous, including a total of 2,600 tickets sold for the two-night 1984 show, A Decade of Harmony. And the Saturday night performance was a sellout. Now, there's a name on the rise who I believe deserves recognition. His name is Mark Stock. Mark joined the chorus in 1980 after a job change and relocating to Shelby. Now, Mark had already been the frontline director for the Singing Buckeyes, multiple times they were district champions, and having him join us was a real shot in the arm with his available coaching and music skills. Then in 1994, Mark had an idea. He created a small ensemble from the Chordsmen. We refer to it as Buckeye North. This paved the way for about 12 Mansfield men to sing at the International Convention in Pittsburgh that year. For many of us, it realized a dream of singing on the international stage. I know it's dark up there, but we want to thank Mark Stock for his contribution over the years to this show. And the Singing Buckeyes came in 10th that year. I still think that's the highest they've ever finished, which is pretty cool. After directing 21 shows, Dave Crocker decided to step aside, and after reviewing numerous applicants, the board decided upon a young man, a second-generation barbershopper from Columbus, and he is here with us today. Please welcome Mike Banish. Mike, what motivated you to take on the Mansfield directing job?
Well, the fame and fortune, of course. but really, we were working in with part of Ohio, my chorus in Columbus. I was under the mentorship of Steve Summer and Don Luce, and we were kind of redefining what a small chorus could do with some of Don's exercises and coaching. So I thought it was an opportunity for me to share some of that with a new chorus, a different chorus, and bring it up to Mansfield. And so that's why I came up.
What do you remember from the first couple of rehearsals?
I remember bringing my quartet from Hart, Ohio. We had learned a new song together, and it was called Precious Moments, and we brought it to the chorus here to Mansfield and taught chorus for the first couple of rehearsals using the quartet method. It was really a great way to introduce the chorus to a new song, as well as show them that, you know, that they can learn some new music in a very quick couple of weeks. And it made a success for the chorus, made a success for me, obviously, to do that right off the bat, and kind of got us moving.
Well, thank you very much for some creative ideas. Along the way, your fine work and dedication earned you the Fun Center Chordsman Barbershopper of the Year Award in 1997. So we thank you for taking part in today's anniversary celebration. Take your spot in the director's square out there. Directing a song the chorus learned in the second decade. Ladies and gentlemen, from the first hello to the last goodbye, Mike Banish and the Fun Center Chordsmen.
From the first day.
Now, during our second decade, the creativity and content of our annual shows was overflowing with fully staged productions, such as Whistle Stop Barbershop, The Phantom of the Barbershop, A Salute to Disney, and College Days, where the guys were all members of Sigma Tau Theta fraternity. And the guest quartets were off the hook. Four soon-to-be international champions performed in Mansfield. Yesteryear, Second Edition, The Ritz, and Joker's Wild, along with seniors quartet champs, the Silvertones. Stepping forward is Trevor Garibrand to direct a song that we learned in the early years and still love to sing today, Darkness on the Delta.
So I stepped aside and was in a church in Galleon down the road.
And I'm not sure, I still don't know, I know how the Dave Crocker found out I was here. And he came down and recruited me to come up and do some leadership and spent a couple years directing before I moved on. It was great.
Well, you started singing Barbershop like Nettie did at Bowling Green. And it seems like your life would have been much different if you were not in that men's chorus.
Yeah, Artie Matthews is kind of the father of a lot of BG guys who want to be the national champs or are in Barbershop or directing music all over the country.
Unfortunately, we only had you for one annual show. Uptown Sound was the guest quartet. And you directed a novelty tune that had its roots in the BGSU men's chorus. So Mark, the honor is yours for Please, Mr. Columbus.
Bye. think I'm gonna cry. Bye, 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 bye
Thank you.
Senator Doug Smales. Now, we're going to back up a little bit here for our next feature director. The early 2000s had a distinct Bowling Green imprint. Upon Bart Blake's relocating and leaving the Meadsfield chapter, he personally found his replacement. That man was Steve Kovach of Uptown Sound Quartet, also a product of the Bee Gees Men's Chorus. Please welcome Steve Kovach. Steve, I'll be the first to say we had a lot of fun during your time directing. I'm sure it was a struggle at times, but you stuck around for 10 years. Yeah, share some of the memories from that time.
The memories of that time are all surrounded around relationships. The guys, just week after week, month after month, year after year, just a wonderful time with all of the guys. Looking at the pictures prior to the show just brings back so many memories, just a flood of memories of guys who have gone before us, of course, guys who are up here on the risers today. Just a wonderful time.
Yeah, well, do you have, and I was thinking of a few things to myself, singing at the Rehab Telethon. I know you really enjoyed the Mansfield Memorial Day.
Memorial Day was always a great sing out. It was more than just a sing out, it was being part of the community. It was honoring those who served, who were serving at the time, and to hear the names of the people each year, whether it was whether we finished in the cemetery for a number of years or the center of town for a number of years. It was always a wonderful sing-out. And of course, all of the sing-outs that we did in this community, in the greater community of Central Ohio, and of course the Sunday morning services in the summer were wonderful as well.
Yeah, during your time, we really became the patriotic chorus, also developing a Veterans Day ceremony during your tenure that we still do today. So thank you very much for that, for your influence there, and for joining us today. So I'll let you get on out there to direct Steve Kovach directing Beer Barrel Polka, a song we introduced on the 2007 show, Tailgating with the Chorusmen. Sure, Steve Kovach.
Good cheer. Now's the time to roll the bell.
graduating from Bowling Green with his music education degree, Trevor Garibrand was hired to teach at Crestview High School. Soon after, Trevor was encouraged to check out the fun set of Portsmouth. He must have liked it because that was 17 years ago. Joining in 2007, and along the way, serving as section leader, active quartet singer, and assistant director, in 2015, Trevor directed his first Portsmouth show. And 11 years later, here he is, folks, still leading the way. Trevor, come on over here. So as the years go by, this really becomes a family, doesn't it?
Yes, yes it does. I was quoted in the Mansfield News Journal when they asked me, hey, you're a lot younger than the rest of the guys in the chorus. How does that feel? I said, well, every Monday night I walk in and I have a group of old uncles and grandpas that are my beck and call. So, yes, it does turn into a family atmosphere. And these guys have been nothing but supportive and helped me grow as a person and as a director myself. So I couldn't do without this family atmosphere.
I remember when I was the young guy. Anyway, you've been able to include your own family, too.
Yes, so last year, my son Keaton joined the chorus. So if you notice somebody that probably brings down the average age of the chorus by about 15 years, that's him. He's been singing with us for 2 years. This is his second show. And also, my wife gets involved. She's emceed a couple of shows. I think, though, she does it for the new dresses, really, because whenever she emceed a show, it meant I had to fork over money for a new dress. So she was a little jealous at you, Rusty, that she didn't get a new dress this
morning. Well, I get to pick out a new dress. Well, take your place, and let's celebrate the Garibrand decade, first with a popular song from Toy Story, You've Got a Friend in Me.
Hole in the ground. It is a memory I will never forget.
Prayer for the Children was written by Kurt Vester. Kurt was watching the news and seeing the Civil War break out in a country that was known then as Yugoslavia. It was happening between the Serbians, the Croatians, and the Bosnians. He spent quite a bit of time in the 1970s in that country, so it was very near and dear to his heart. What he was seeing every day in the news was really giving him deep feelings of hopelessness. Kurt decided to put his feelings into a melody. He started with, "Can you hear? Can you see? Can you feel?" All those emotions. As he was working through it, he started thinking about the children and how their families were being torn apart by the Civil War. So he finished writing the song with those children in mind. In 2005, I sang this thinking about myself as a student in high school during 9/11. Even now, we can apply these same feelings to the children in Ukraine who might be having those same thoughts and feelings. We hope you enjoy Prayer of the Children.
Children. silence in their shattered world. Angry gods, preach a gospel full of hate. Blood of the innocent on their hands. Cry, Jesus.
Good afternoon. We'll be performing a couple of songs of faith today. The first one I think you'll recognize if you're old enough to remember Peter, Paul, and Mary. It's Very Last Day. And then our second song is probably one of the most popular and well-known gospel tunes, Precious Lord.
Oh, The clouds were gray, a gust the wind caught my toupee and it blew my toupee. I want my brother to try and find the head of hair that once was mine. A sudden breeze, I almost died when it blew by you. I'm going back out there to find my hair that blew by you. It's a blonde toupee with a touch of gray that blew by you. I get no peace of mind without that peace of mind. My head looks like a baby's behind. I'm going right back out there to find my hair that blew by you. Okay, yeah. I'm going back out there to find my hair that blew by you.
So sad but true.
It's a fun to pay that cost me 3 weeks' pay that blew by you. I get no peace of mind without that peace of mind. My head looks like a baby's behind. I'm going right back out there to find my hair that blew by you.
You should always. you sang for me when we were sailing on an emerald bay, and like a boat out on the ocean, I'm rocking you to sleep. The water's dark and deep inside this ancient heart. You'll always be
in the still of the night.
quartet. It features a near, dear, and friend to my heart. Mr. Doug Smeltz was one of my mentors growing up, as he stated in his interview. I would not be the director I am today without Mr. Doug Smeltz, so I owe him all kinds of kudos and thank yous, and I can never say it publicly enough how much he taught me and he poured himself into me to make me the director I am today. So I am super excited for this next quartet. So please put your hands together for one of JAD's premier senior quartets, Rerouted! Senior Quartet Contest, and it was so much fun.
And so we'd like to do the package now that we did when we sang on the stage in New York City.
Stand there just a moment, darling. Let me catch my breath. I've never seen a picture quite so lovely. How did you ever learn to look so lovely? Moonlight becomes you. It grows with your hair.
We call it home, where
unless you throw money, it would have to be $100 bills, okay? But it's been a pleasure being here, and my wife is out there somewhere, Shelley. Those last two songs I dedicated to her, and because she's such a wonderful wife to have. And I know Tim's thinking the same way about Angie, and Donna about Loretta, and then, what's your name? Keith and his wife. So we'd like to finish up, though, with kind of a up-tune, which we don't do a lot of work, kind of lovers, not fighters. And but we want to finish with a song that we love to sing, and we're going to go and sing in churches.
Well, I woke up this morning feeling fine. I woke up with hell on my mind. I woke up with joy in my soul, 'cause I knew my Lord had control. Well, I knew I was walking in the light, 'cause I'd been on my knees in the night and prayed till the Lord gave a sign. And now I'm feeling mighty fine.
Something I your eyes on me. I said, you're holding back. She said, shut up and dance with me. This woman is my destiny. She said, ooh, ooh, shut up and dance with me. We were victims of the night. Mechanical, physical, trivial life. To them was to the face and the fading light. Oh, we were bound to get together, bound to get together. She took my arm, I don't know how it happened. We took the floor and she said, oh, don't you dare look back. Just keep your eyes on me. I said, you're holding back. She said, shut up. Thank you.
are welcome to come join us on stage for our society theme song. So go ahead and make a move if you want to come up here and sing with us. We would love that. I'm Rusty Cates. It's been a pleasure to be here this afternoon. Let's keep the whole world singing.